Hi friend, welcome back. This is Dr. Iqbal and you are watching Vela Baba YouTube channel. Today I will talk about the study permit or the study visa, and I will focus on two types of study visa. One is SDS, the second is general. So what is the procedure, how to apply, who can apply, and related questions will be answered. Friends, if you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing it, because you never know that there would be a lot of people in your circles who might be needing this video. So let's dive into our video. The study permit is a document that allows foreign nationals other than Canadian to study at designated learning institutions in Canada. Most foreign nationals need a study permit to study in Canada. Make sure you have all the documents you need before you apply. You should apply before you travel to Canada. Basically, a study permit is usually valid for the length of your study program plus an extra 90 days for preparation to leave Canada or apply to extend your stay. If you are taking prerequisite courses, your school asks you to take courses before they accept you into the main. You have conditional acceptance. Your study permit will be valid for the length of those courses plus 1 year. When you get accepted into the main program, you must then apply to extend your stay as a student. If you will finish your studies after your study permit expires. If you don't finish your course before the date on your permit, you must apply to extend your stay as a student. If you don't, you will need to stop studying and leave Canada. If you finish your studies early, your permit will stop being valid 90 days after you complete your studies, no matter what day is printed on the study permit. You have completed your studies on the date your school first notifies you by completion letter, transcript, degree, or diploma. You must provide proof of the date your school notifies you or the date you get your degree, diploma, or certificate. If you don't have a proof, the IRCC will use the earliest issue date on the document. IRC may confirm this date with your school. One is SDS, which is Student Direct Stream, and the other is General. So what is the difference between these two? The SDS is for those students who live in China, India, Pakistan, Philippines, and Vietnam. And the General is for all those students who wish to study in Canadian institutions other than these five countries. So I will focus on the SDS, but the terms, condition, the procedure equally applies to the general study permit. Processing time for SDS is 20 days, but it may take longer time. Again, subject to completion of all the formalities by you. The fee for the study permit is Canadian dollar 150. To complete your document, you have to immediately get your biometrics done and complete all the document formalities as early as possible so you get the visa timely. Now please remember that this study permit is not a visa. If you travel to Canada, you have to apply for the visitor visa. So when you apply for the study permit, the visitor visa will also be given to you. To be eligible for faster processing through the SDS, you must be a legal resident living in China, India, Pakistan, Philippines, or Vietnam. You should have an acceptance letter from post-secondary designated learning institution. You have paid the tuition fees for your first year of study. You should live outside of Canada when you apply. You have a guaranteed investment certificate, GIC, of Canadian dollar 10,000. You should get a medical exam before you apply, if you need one. You should also get a police certificate before you apply, if you need one. You should have your most recent secondary or post-secondary school's transcripts. You should have language test result that shows band 6 or higher in each skill, listening, writing, reading, and speaking, IELTS, for example, and any additional documents to support your application. You can bring spouse and children. You may bring your spouse or partner and children with you to Canada. Your spouse, partner, and dependent children may also be able to get faster processing on visitor visa, work permit, and study visa. You must complete and submit their applications at the same time as your own. If you don't, their application will not be processed on the faster track. When you apply online, you have to indicate that you have family members coming with you to Canada. By doing so, you will be able to complete their application with yours. You must apply online to get faster processing for your study permit. There is no paper application for the Student Direct Stream. Make sure you include all the required documents with your application. Before you apply online, you should make sure you have the following. Number one, instruction guide to fill out your forms. Scanner a camera to create electronic copies of your document. Valid credit or debit card to make payment. Pay your biometric fee. You need to give your biometrics. You should pay the biometric fee when you submit your application online. If you don't pay these fees, you may not be able to process your application faster. Get instructions to apply online. Select country or territory you are applying from to get your local visa office instruction and to apply online. For example, you have to select your country, like Pakistan, India, or from where you are applying. You need an account to apply online. You can use your account to pay your fees, submit your application, check the status of your application. When you apply, make sure you meet the eligibility for faster processing. Include all the documents you need. Follow your visa office instructions in case you need to provide other documents. Visa office instruction like IMM5814, you can download it from the IRC website, link of which is in the description. Friends, I'm sharing this clip which shows guide 5269 related to all the students who apply outside Canada. So link of this is also given in the description. And this guide shows how to and what to do before you apply, what documents you need to gather, you have to complete, how to complete your application, the procedure for payment of fees, and then submission of your application online. And then also, this shows what happens next and how to apply for temporary resident visa, application photographs, specification also given. Because your study permit is not a visa, you have to apply for TRV. And also, this is the list of documents you need to complete application, link of which is also given in the description. This is the application for study permit made outside of Canada, IMM 1294. Family information you have to give on the form IMM 5645 or 5707. This is a document list, IMM 5483, and you have to declare statutory declaration of common law union, and the form is IMM5409, if applicable. Custodian declaration, custodian for minors studying in Canada, IMM5646, if applicable. Use of representative, IMM5476, if applicable. Authority to release personal information to a designated individual, IMM5475, if applicable. So please remember that you may be required to complete additional supporting documents upon request of a visa officer. Last but not the least, my request is to give correct information, because any false information subsequently identified may not only be delay your case, but also disqualify you forever. So give correct information, whatever the visa officer asks, and also double check that you are using the right form. So thank you very much for having me. Take care of yourself and have a great time. See you in next video. Till that, bye-bye.